Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple milling machine tool. It is a reamer which is going to use for the enlargement of hole. If we cut any hole small, this is the main function of reamer. We can enlarge any kind of hole with the help of different size of reamer. See, so we will make with the help of flex command. I hope you like it. So let's see how to do in SolidWorks. Now here let's start to create our D16 reamer. Reamer, you know, this is basically used to enlarge any kind of hole which is made by default small. So let's start here. Choose front plane sketch, and let's start with line. Little taper. And this one comes up to here, connect, exit, choose smart dimension, and overall length we will define 140 mm, and the distance from here to this point 52 mm. Choose a star point and put one star here. From here to this point 72 mm. Select this star point with this point. Oh, make it 9 mm, and from this star to end 56 mm. Now here we need to create some relation. Let's make some dimension 135 degrees. The same we have to create with this. Okay, 135 mm, that's fine. (16.01/2 mm). (6.5 mm). Okay, let's down this one, and this one choose, delete this relation and make it taper. Delete this relation. Let's define this first, this point to here, this one 17.306/2 mm. The same here, let's define this point 16.856/2 mm. Now this is the fully defined. Let's define the angle 82 degrees. Now geometry is fully defined. Let's check distance from here to this point. Okay, it's by default selected. Corner fillet keep 1 mm, radius 1 mm, sketch chamfer. 1.5 millimeter and select this corner. Okay, now here we put all the dimensions, so I think no need other things. This all angle and everything we defined. Select revolve boss base. See, okay. Now this is the main body of Reamer. Now choose top plane, a sketch, normal. Now here we want to make some cutouts. Select corner rectangle. Draw a center line. Make sure it is horizontal and connected with center origin point, or that's fine if it is in center. Now let's define the distance. Millimeter. Choose mirror, select the full rectangle. No, better do one more thing. Corner fillet, select this corner 3 millimeter. Okay, mirror entity, select this full rectangle and mirror about this line. Okay, now choose defined gap 2.5 millimeter. That's also okay. That's fine. Extruded cut. Keep end condition through all both, so that it will cut in both direction. Select here. Okay. Now see, this is the grip actually. Now it's time to cut some flute here. Sketch, select center line and start from here to this point, to this point. Choose smart dimension and define the angle 120 degree. The same here, 120 degree. That's it. Now here choose 3-point rectangle from here to this point and drag. Millimeter. Select here corner rectangle. Corner radius, let's say 0.5, and choose this corner. Okay, smart dimension, keep angle 85 degree. This, now here we defined all the dimensions. Now here see, this circle is little outside, so it will not cut, so we need to cut this one also. So we have to apply some other strategy. Again choose the same thing, one millimeter. Now we are going to cut both the things. Okay, or directly delete midline. That's it. Select here fully defined sketch. Okay, now select extruded cut. Select here 60 degree. Okay, 16 millimeter, not degree. That's it. Now select this face sketch, normal. Now we want to cut this face actually, so we will do one thing. Select this line convert entity. Now the every all the lines are converted. Connect with this line. Exit. Select both the lines. Make tangent relation. Here also make tangent relation. And here select these two lines collinear. That's it. Now let's define this. Twenty-eight point eight millimeter, because it now after putting this 22.8 here, check whether it's open or not. I feel this corner is not met, so select both the endpoints because it creates problem if it will not met. Let's choose here line and start from this point to this point. Okay. Now choose your revolve cut. Select this upper line. Clear the line here. And here choose full rectangle we want to cut. Make sure it is not going to coincide here. I hope it's not going to meet here also. Let's check 360 degree. Okay, that's perfect. That's it. Now it's time to make multiple number of patterns, so choose here circular pattern. Here drop down this menu, extruded cut and revolve cut, and here choose a circular face. We want 6 number of patterns. See, 360 degree. Okay, that's it. See, now it's time to make some cutouts here. So select this face, sketch, normal. Select this sketch, show. Select the outer circle. Convert entities. Now choose here line, connect from this point to this point. Exit. Again choose center line and draw one line. Exit. Now let's define this line angle 90 degree. Now the angle between these two lines 15 degree. Okay, now select this line and this point coincide. That's it, our geometry is fully defined. Choose your circular pattern, center point, select this line, make 3 number of patterns here. We want 3 number of patterns. Choose equal spacing 360 degree. That's it. Trim entity, power trim, cut this one and this one. Now we have 3 fluids to going to cut. So okay. Now select here extruded cut. I hope you remember this dimension. Up to 60 millimeter. Okay. Now hide this geometry. Now this is the body is ready. Now we will see how to make twist or how to give the twist to this cutouts or this fluid or this remover. So just go to insert, and here you will find feature option and choose here flex. Now it's time to give some twist to this thread or pitch. So first select the body, that's it. Now here you can see trim plane 1, plane 2. Plane 2 we will keep as it is, and we will turn plane 1 degree. Here you will define, select twisting, hard edges, and degree let's define, we will keep minus 30 degree. See, it's going to little tapered, but the gap is, we don't want to twist full body, we will twist from somewhere in mid. So go to plane 1 and here define 70. Now look, this is your plane 70, it comes here and we will twist from here. See, now you can see here plane 1, plane 2. Plane 2 we kept 0, that's fine. And plane even make minus 40. So it's quite more turn. Select OK. Now let's see the angle of reamer. Look, it is twisted. See. So this is the simple method to create a simple reamer. It is very useful tool in milling machine. The main function of this one to just cut the, enlarge the hole which is going to be cut by default is small. So I hope you like it. Let's define some color. Go to appearance, polished steel, let's say chrome. Oh wow, so I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. If you have any comment, just write down below. I'll try to answer each and every question. Thanks for watching.